Hey guys, welcome to the shop. Today's video is really just covering a fly cutter and why you would use one. So we're just going to present the part to you. But you see, we got a pretty good finish on that. We hand fed. So this is hand fed at about a 10,000th depth of cut on our little tiny baby shop made fly cutter. And these really are just single point cutting tools. So in our case, it's flattening out a larger area than I'm really comfortable using a face mill for. Now, I have a 2-inch face mill, which will cover the same area as this fly cutter, but you know, it's got aluminum inserts in it. It's an aluminum face mill. It's not very good for steel, and this gets a much better surface finish. Now, the downside to fly cutters is they're inherently imbalanced. As you see, we have an eccentric weight on here. And we have a cutout on this side. Now, if I were to balance this, what I could do is just take a little material off this side. Now, this is a very small fly cutter. The body of it is about 1.6 inches in diameter. It's not a big, heavy tool. It's not much for this size mill. You actually don't even feel vibration in the table using it at 660 RPM. That being said, in an ideal world, I would mass balance this or, you know, make efforts to get a more balanced tool. We would get a marginally better finish. I think in this case, really what we're seeing is an uneven travel speed because I'm hand feeding this. I don't have a power feed on this machine yet. And tool grind. I'm still learning how to grind tools for a fly cutter. I've never really used one for as long as I've been at this. I don't think they're mission critical tools. Really what I've always done if I needed a large flat surface is honestly just broke up the surface grinder. So we're learning together, guys. Now fly cutters are really interesting because they give you an inexpensive tool to flatten large areas when you don't have a very rigid machine. Now, I do have a Bridgeport J-head. This is a relatively rigid machine by hobby standards, but it's still a relatively flaccid machine in the grand scheme of things. Now, for those of you who are using benchtop mills, which would practically fit on my work surface here, these are great tools because even using a half inch end mill on those is like the absolute limits of what they can handle. I mean, sometimes even 3/8 or 1/4 inch. And you also often don't even have the same RPM I have on this 70-year-old J-head. This machine is limited to 2,720 RPM, assuming 60 hertz electricity. And I've talked to some people and read that some people have benchtop hobby machines that are limited to like 1800 RPM. Now, if you're so RPM limited, you can't spin the tools quick enough to get a good surface finish, especially carbide. I do use a lot of carbide here with low surface speed for it. But you see, I mean, I'm very happy with that surface finish on this part. It's, I think, adequate for purpose. So you have real advantages there on the small, light, basically tinker toy machines where rigidity is a huge issue and you couldn't really even consider using a 1-inch face mill. But as we discussed earlier, again, we have balance issues. You can't really take much of a cut with this. Playing with this off camera, this really got scarier on a 20,000th depth of cut. It was scary. You could feel things deflecting and shaking. And I think the practical limit on these is 12 to 15,000ths, at least this particular tool on this particular machine in this particular vise. You might be able to get these getting a much deeper depth of cut, or you may be tapped out at 5,000ths. So, you know, there's a lot of unknowns. You're going to have to feel out your particular machine combination. Now, thanks for watching, guys. I hope you found this interesting. And if anyone is interested, we can talk about making these. And I can show you some really simple setups. Counting lathe time on this, I think I made this tool in about an hour and 15 minutes. And grinding it. Because really all I did was take a scrap piece of steel and turn a 7/8 inch shank on it, and I put two cuts on it and two holes in it. So again, thanks for watching, guys.